Hey, this is Sasha. Thanks for joining me in today's video. And what I want to share with you today are side hustles worth it? Should you really do a side hustle and do something on the side? So stay tuned. I'm going to answer this question for you. All right, so you might be interested in getting into a side hustle, whether you're looking to do gigs on Fiverr, childcare, be an Airbnb host, have a podcast, create your own blog, a website, affiliate marketing. There's so many different things you could do to make money on the side. And virtually it's unlimited of depending on your creativity. But the big question is it worth it? Should you really do a side hustle? And I think the important part behind this is to look at your objective behind the side hustle. So think of your objective. So many people start out doing side hustles without having a clear objective and purpose, because if you have a different objective than somebody else, the type of side hustle that you should do should be completely different. Now, before we continue, I do want to give you some insights. Is check out some of the freebies that we have on our website here at MyLittleNestEgg.com. You could go ahead and get a list of different side hustles and things you can do to make money on the side locally and digitally and much more. So anyways, with that being said, let's take a look here at the objectives. Now, here's just a couple of objective ideas for you to think about. So you might be looking to have a side hustle to save for your emergency fund, to save maybe for a vacation that's 3 months or 4 months down the road. Maybe you wanna go ahead and pay for college in some way. Or what you wanna do is take your side hustle and transform it into a business because you wanna leave your job, right? So everybody has a different clear-cut purpose. And I will tell you that saving for an emergency fund or a vacation is a lot different than wanting to leave your job. If you're looking to just, you know, go on vacation and just save a little extra money for that vacation or for a little bucket, well, in that case, that type of side hustle is less important of what you do rather than, hey, let me just figure out a way to make money quickly and just go ahead in the sense of not just generate money quickly, but in the sense of, hey, let me start up quick. I'm okay getting a little bit less per hour, but I just want to get up and going, accumulate some funds, and then I'm done. Because remember, in the end here, you are done. Now, there's a big difference when you want to transform it into a business and leave your job, because there's not really a done point until maybe you sell your business. So you have to look at here, this is going to be looking for bigger growth because you're looking to leave your job and transform it into your full-time income. So it's a big difference when you're trying to just, hey, I just want to make some $2,000 to go on vacation, or I'm trying to make, you know, $100,000 a year to replace my job. So everybody's at a different point and you have to have that clear objective. And I think what a lot of people do is they get into a side hustle thinking, hey, I'm gonna go ahead and do a side hustle to make some extra money on the side to pay my bills, just lighten up my load. You know, they don't have an objective in mind. And then they wanna go ahead and transform it into a business. But when in reality, if you go back in time and you think about starting a business, you would have probably done something completely different than that side hustle. So remember, starting a business is much different than just having a side hustle. And then eventually, yes, of course, it can develop into a business. But if you think with the end in mind, right, starting out with the bigger picture, you might have done and structured things a little bit differently. So think about this in your side hustle. If you're getting in and you're doing some lawn care because you're 15 years old and you want to make some money on the side, well, do you want to transform it into a business? Think about it. 5 years from now, 10 years from now, are you still going to have those same clients? When you go to college, are you going to go to college? If you're not, well, are you going to still stay in that area? Because if you plan to move, well, more than likely, you're going to lose your clientele, so you'll have to sell your lawn care business. So again, think about these things. You know, are you going to want to do that when you're 50 or 60 years old? Or will your bones hurt? Will your body hurt? Will you want to do something else? Or are you going to be that type of kid that's really committed for the next 50 years to doing this business? So again, another thing to think about. So that's what you want to go in and look at your side hustle as a clear objective. Because if you've got just a side hustle where you're looking to just make $2,000 to $3,000 and then you're out, there's nothing wrong with that. You could do all sorts of things. You could even do 2 to 3 side hustles, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, and you know, sprinkle the pot from different areas. But if you're looking to drive a business to replace, let's say, your income, to leave your job, to do something different, well, then you have to think about it with the business concepts in mind. And I definitely would recommend you check out our other channel, Backstage Income, for more business kinds of tips and insights. But with that being said, starting with an objective will give you a clear-cut purpose, direction, and it'll keep you focused in line for the end in mind, and that will be a better route because now you'll have a direction and that'll allow you to not deviate from the path as much. So anyways, I hope this gives you some thoughts and helps and insights because otherwise, you know, your business objectives might be a little bit different. Your side hustle objectives might be a little different. So whatever the case is, there's so many different things you could do. Virtually, it just comes down to fulfilling other people's needs and values. And if you can add value to their life, save them time, save them money, give them some sort of pleasure, then in the end, you can fulfill a product or service and really make more side income or convert it into full-time income. Anyways, thank you so much for joining me. Feel free to check out some of those freebies that we have on our website by clicking the link right over here, or subscribe to the YouTube channel if you're brand new, or keep watching some more videos. Anyways, thanks again, and I will see you next time.